Hello everybody, my name is Julien Pastor and today we are going to talk about pathogen detection inside ground beef. Let's go!
You don't want to go for a ride, do you? We could get out of the palace, see the world.
Is it safe?
Sure, it'd be a pleasure.
So today I am with Florent Brossat from Merck. How are you, Florent?
Nice, and you?
I'm fine, thank you. We are going to talk about ground beef detection. Florent, let us know what we should detect inside a ground beef. What kind of pathogen, I mean?
Very, very, very easy, I would say. This is the two main pathogens that our customer have to detect are Salmonella species and steak, mainly in Europe. Except in UK, where they are still testing for E. coli 0157H7.
To detect this kind of pathogen, Florent, what kind of solution we can use? I mean, culture media, PCR, immuno, what's your advice?
The best solution in Merck opinion at the moment is real-time PCR in combination with immunomagnetic separation, and in Merck we have a specific solution for that.
What's your solution and what's the key point of this solution?
The name of this solution is GDS, for genetic detection system. They have two key points in this solution, in my opinion. The first key point is that we have developed a unique enrichment broth for Salmonella and steak. The sample size that you could analyze is between 25 gram until 375 gram, with a minimum incubation time of 10 hours, which is extremely interesting for customers to have very quick results.
And what's the second key point?
The second key point is the combination of the two technology, IMS and real-time PCR. IMS, it's immunomagnetic separation. Then we are using specific antibodies to capture the target pathogens. After this first step, we can detect these pathogens with real-time PCR.
Okay, so you mean with this second key point, it's about sensitivity and performances. That's what you mean?
Yeah, the three main words to define GDS is really sensitivity, specificity, and robustness.
And what kind of system are you using to achieve this kind of performance?
For sure, we have one thermocycler, the Rotor-Gene Q, that we are using for the real-time PCR detection. It's a very nice equipment, well designed for this type of technology. And we have developed with a partner a specific robot called Pipette Max, in order to automatize the preparation of the sample, in order to have a very easy solution for food industry.
So thank you very much, Florent. I think we have everything now to detect pathogen inside ground beef. If you have any question for me or for Florent, please leave your comment below this video. Thank you very much. Bye.
Thank you, Julien.
Thank you, Florent.